Here in the halfway point of regulation, Predators down 2-0. Shots 14-13, so a relatively low shot volume so far for both teams. Anaheim, if you're just joining us, scored on a power play goal from Nick Ritchie in the first period, then tallied a shorthanded goal from Jacob Silverberg here in the second. The special teams playing a big part, and now all kinds of discussion in the faceoff. Scott, I'm not sure what's going on. And we'll continue to talk it over. Johansson is the guy that they're talking to. I'm not sure about what.
An exchange between Johansson and Alfonso, perhaps.
Maybe the
linesman has the ability. He hears something that is... Now, I'm talking about words that are offside. Not a puck or a player that's offside. Words that are offside. He has the ability to point that out to the official. They'll confer and assess an unsportsmanlike minor. Coach Laviolette is demanding an explanation of all that.
4-on-3 power play in overtime. Richards again to handle. Mike Richards in front, scores! No goal, it was knocked in by a high stick.
Well, I think it's goalie interference, I think, and he's going to call and make a penalty out of this too. Pronger takes the off the defensive position, goes, stands in front of the net, obviously because of his size. And this is what they're talking about. He backed right into Mika Kiprusoff. Good hard shot by Richards in the top shelf where he's got to go. But Pronger goes to the box.
Great Richard call, Charlie.
Just waiting and waiting. Well, I'm not looking. He's outside. Well, I'm not looking at that. I'm not seeing the same play that the referee is at this point. Pronger's
unless
outside.
It happened earlier.
Well, no, he's got control. Oh, he's hit the hand. That's what they're talking about. Avery did that a few years ago, about getting the hand in front of his face. There you could see it as they slowed it down. We could see that hand coming out right into the face of Mika Kiprusoff.
Backus tips a pass up to Bergeron. Marchand going to the goal. And that pass intended for Marchand, deflected on a play by Dougie Hamill. So more rough stuff, and Brad Marchand just grabbed onto Michael Frolik's cage. He's wearing that protection because he broke his jaw last December.
That's the one thing when you're playing with a broken jaw, and it's pretty well healed, but still, I've broken my jaw before, and it takes a while for the effects to go away, and it's one of those injuries you can't hide. You're wearing the face mask, so look who's going to the box, man. Talked about that line. That line that sometimes you go over and sometimes you stay right on it. And there's an example of Marchand just going over it and taking a bad penalty. And right there going to the net. And you see Frolik goes down, gets a little bit of a high stick. Then Marchand comes over after. And watch what he does here in the scrum. Right there, grabs right onto the face protection of Frolik. I'm not sure what he's thinking right there. You're going to get an enforcement. You're going to get a ref after the whistle.
Going. Look at this crowd standing again. Pittsburgh is getting mesmerized by this Columbus team. Conduct penalty to Nick Foligno.
He's not happy, and I don't blame him one bit. He comes in and he actually slows down. I mean, how do you stop the snow from moving? It's not like he sprayed him in the face or anything. This call came late. It's a poor reaction call. There is no way that I think that's a penalty. There are more things that go on in a game. He literally slowed down skating when he saw Fleury going to freeze the puck.
Kucherov picks up an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty.
Well, he kicked him. You can't go around kicking people. And Connolly looked at him and said, hey, like, you just kicked me. What are you doing? Like, it's, you know, run into him, shoulder if you want to stop him, push him, whatever. But I don't think kicking him's a good idea.
Well, that's the frustration he's got to be feeling. We've talked about it a couple times tonight. No excuse, obviously. It's a stupid thing to do.
He never passed, so that threw me off. I didn't think he had that many helpers. No way.
Wilson and Phaneuf need to be separated. Linesman Matt McPherson getting in there in a hurry.
pushing and shoving there a little bit. Wilson talking to Dion Phaneuf.
Dion's always physical. Dion always gets under your skin. People like to go back at Dion.
And by the way, he needs thick skin, being the captain of the Toronto Maple Leafs.
You ain't kidding. Amazing when you look at the Maple Leafs point scoring. You see Phaneuf and Riley at the top, the two defenders. See, Tom Wilson's not going to stand for very much more of this.
No. And neither are the referees.
Phaneuf is just trying to goad him into a penalty.
And they're both going to go here. The referee's not going to buy it. That was just Wilson or just Dion. Both of them will go. We'll have 4-on-4 hockey. Here it is right off the face off. They're talking. First cross check, second cross check. And he gets a couple more licks in than Dion did, but both of them have a seat for a pair.
Mike Babcock, though, losing his captain and one of his top defenders in that trade-off. 4-on-4 for the next couple minutes. Just past the 3-minute mark of the third in a 1-1 game.
Same page. So one thing having one or two players that are fast that can get on you, but when you have everybody thinking the same way at all times, offensively and defensively, then you're going to have success.
Are they
going to
give Bertuzzo a penalty here for a little snow shower? I believe they are.
Really? You know what? Robert Bertuzzo is following up on the play, and he's going right to the crease. I know they cracked down on this a couple of years ago, and they called it more and more. But see, he's following up right there. He's got full speed here, and then he stops. I mean,
he didn't even hit him with the snow.
And then he takes a cross check from behind by Ryan Suter. And I know Brouwer was over in the far corner trying to get Suter to retaliate. But there he's following up. What's he supposed to do? Is he supposed to skate by? The coach tells you to stop in front of the net. That is just a poor call.
That's a tough call. Very, very.
No, that's a poor call.
Yeah. That's a brutal call. How's that?
There's a big difference with a player that does it on purpose, especially, you know, a lot of agitators will do that. But that one there, he's following up the puck that's just being covered. What if that puck gets squirted loose by the goaltender and he skates by and the puck is in front? He gets benched. He's doing what he's supposed to do.
2-2, works it to center. Now here's a break for Legwan. And he can't get the pass across. Well defended by Vlasic.
And he had to hustle across to the middle because Burns came over from the other side and kind of surprised Mark-Edward Vlasic.
Big hit on Couture by 2-2. And then 2-2 runs into Ryan Kloh. Kloh's glove is off.
Kloh was going to defend Logan Couture. So he was going to, Ryan Kloh, drop the gloves with Jordan 2-2. Jordan 2-2 comes across, hits Logan Couture, finishes with a check. Good hit, nothing wrong with that. Ryan Kloh comes over because he's going to protect his teammates. What Ryan Kloh does, Jordan 2-2 says, no, thank you.
And there will be a penalty on the play to Kloh.
Probably
unsportsmanlike. What?
Probably unsportsmanlike. He dropped his gloves. So I think that's why he's getting it. Unsportsmanlike or delay of game or... I'm not sure. Check it out one more time as Jordan 2-2 comes across. He hits him within and finishes the check within time. I think Ryan Kloh thought that Logan Couture was worse off than he was. Logan bounced up, but Jordan 2-2 did not engage Ryan Kloh.
You are right. It is unsportsmanlike.
Yeah. He dropped
his stick, and I think he dropped one glove.
Yeah, but that was like, I was going to drop the glove, and you know that one next glove was coming off, and the punch was coming, so...